Welcome everybody, you're watching Mr. Fugu Data Science. As always, the code will be in the link in the description below. Thank you to those who are watching and who subscribed. We are converting JSON objects to data frames using four examples. Then, create a function allowing us to store new nested and non-nested entries. Finally, discuss briefly how large data sets can affect the timing of operations and optimization. Showing an example. Import JSON pandas time numpy. Okay. Do pd.read_json call your file name. Here it's employee data.json. Print off and see what your data looks like. Looks kind of funny. Looks strange. We have a features column with a rows of nested dictionaries. The original data had a key of features where all of the values are a list of nested dictionaries. Okay, that makes sense then. Let's use another method with open, call your file name, and then alias that as data file, and we need to iterate line by line in your data file. Store a variable named data called json.loads your lines of data. Create a new variable where you're creating your data frame of your data. See what your data now looks like. Oh, it looks the same. Well, even though I showed these two examples, they're important because if you time them, there's timing discrepancies. One is faster than the other. I'll show you in the end how you can look at that. Now, let's use our four ways to create our data frames. So we're going to take our read JSON, okay? So create a variable named df where we do our pd.read JSON again and take your file data, and then you want to say create a new variable with whatever name you want to give it that makes sense. Create your data frame of your data, but you're taking the features key, taking all of the values, converting it to a list, then you call the candidate to go inside of your nested values now. So this is kind of piece this together, okay? Let's piece this together. So you're taking your features and all of the values here, which gives you the list of the dictionaries. Then you convert it to a list here, which is separating all your candidates out. Then you're going inside and you're calling your candidate, which will go in here and just print off all of these. Okay? So, now we got that. You need to create a new data frame of that, but that's not going to work because that gets you here. So what do? You do from records, and then that'll get you going. That's a first example. Perfect. Let's do the same thing with JSON normalize. So take the first two portions, paste those in, create a new line that says pd.json_normalize, call the bn, and there we go. This is a little different because it's taking somewhat structured data and flattening it into a list, but it's very useful. We can iterate the traditional way where we say for I in your data, and you call your features where this data was created when you did with open. Okay? But we need to also create some variable to store our list, so then we can now append our iterator where we're going inside of it and calling your candidate, and then we create the data frame of our list. Let's see what that looks like. And there we go. Now we got our third example. Okay, list comprehension, which is great. So just name it whatever makes sense to you. Now we have to say, let's take a value for some sublist in our data where we're going inside of our features key, iterate once more inside of that saying value in the sublist dot values. Okay, and then create your data frame, and there you go. Then I created our fake data, which I won't go into here, but here's what it is. We're taking hiring dates, salary, and healthcare, which are going to add to our existing data. So that comes up here. These are the new columns added to our data. We need to create our function, which allows us to take this data frame, convert it into a JSON file with nested objects or unnested objects. We're going to do that now. So this define our function as df underscore to nested JSON, where we're taking in our parameter of our data frame, the candidate, the time somebody was hired, which will equal their hire date, the salary of this person, and the do they have healthcare? Let's make this look better. Okay. From there, create a variable which will take our features as dictionaries. Oh, sorry. A list of values. Then iterate through key value pairs in our data frame using df.iterrows, and we say create a feature variable taking our candidate, which will store dictionary values, and we're creating a And then we're creating a HR related section, which will take dictionaries. And this one, this example, will do nested entry creation. Okay. So we need to do from our nested entries, we're creating nested entries we're creating, we need to now do a feature where we're saying, let's take our feature candidate. Yeah. So let's take our feature, and then now we're saying, we're going to put inside of our related HR portion the hiring information. So when somebody got hired, and you're calling that from the rows where We're taking our values and you're calling the higher. What is this? No, it goes like this. There. Cut and paste for the salary and healthcare. Do the same thing. Salary, healthcare. Okay, now you need to do iterate and just say, I don't know, prop and candidate. And this call feature your candidate, and then what you're putting inside of it, and you're putting inside the values for this, and then you need your underscore JSON so you can take it and throw it into the features portion that starts in the beginning and append it to that list of values of feature. Then you return everything, and you need to take the column names from your data frame, which was TT, and then you take the new variable you're storing everything as from this function, which would be df2 nested JSON, and you're calling the df update and the column names. And then you get an error from something, which would be let's see what's wrong here. Oh, salary. Is it like this? Yes. Okay. And then we see what that looks like. Perfect. Okay, so our first two entries where we take our candidate, and then we have our first name, last name, and all of our information. Okay, cool. Now we can do the same thing with new entries of non-nested. Okay, this is the non-nested entries portion, because if you notice here, we didn't create a new hire like you did right here. And everything's the same. You just didn't add that. And so you can see what that looks like here. So now if you pay attention, it just gets added into here. So you have your salary, your health care, and the date they are hired versus what it looks like here with the nested, which you'll call your hiring date and then a list of values for those. Okay? So that's the difference for that. Now, what I would like to say finally is your consideration for timing your operations. You should take this into consideration. For example, the with open is faster than using just a regular panda.read. Also, you should notice here there's quite a bit of a difference, 0.011 seconds versus 0.005 seconds. So there's quite a bit of a speed up. If you're using large data, you need to start looking into these considerations because it affects the timing considerably. As always, thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe and turn on that notification bell. Throw me a like if you thought this was useful content. If not, throw a comment and tell me why and give me some feedback so I can make this channel better for everyone. Have a good one. See you in the next video. Bye.